Oh, welcome back to the kitchen. I'm going to try a little experiment tonight. I'm going to take a good, really good recipe for a yogurt cake. And this makes a really moist, rich cake because it's got a full cup of yogurt in it. But I like chocolate cake. So I'm going to add a whole bar of Baker's chocolate. So I already got it melted. Liquid. In the bowl I got 2 blocks of butter, 2 cups of sugar. I'm going to get that mixed together. Then I'm going to add the chocolate, blend it, and then finish off the recipe as normal. And let's see what happens when it comes out of the oven. So first is to get this mixing. We'll let that mix for about 5 minutes. And then we'll add the chocolate. So while that's mixing, this is next. And vanilla goes with that. And 2 1/4 cups of flour already in here. Put in 1/2 teaspoon of soda. And 1/2 teaspoon of salt. Teaspoon of vanilla. Scrape it down and mix it a little bit more. Make sure it's good and mixed. And we're going to add the eggs next. Another scrape. Now we're going to add in the chocolate. Stop and scrape that one. And that's going to about do it. Going to taste that. It's got a nice chocolate flavor. So, now, this. Another quick scrape. So we have a cup of yogurt, we got our flour and dry ingredient mixture. We're going to do this in thirds. We're going to do about a third of this. Just going to blend it in a little bit together. The yogurt. I'm gonna fold that in. Try not to lose any of it. Like so. It almost comes together, and put in the rest of this yogurt. some more. And then throw in the rest of the dry ingredients. You could mix it all together with the paddle if you like, but I find you get a nicer kick if you just stir it like this by hand. Okay, use an all-purpose flour when you're making this cake recipe. If you stir it too much with the paddle, you start to develop the gluten in the flour, and that makes the cake start to go a little tough. You want a nice, moist cake. Oh, that's what that looks like. It's pretty much all incorporated together. And now we're just going to drop it in the pan. It's, the batter seems a little dry compared to a normal white cake batter. So in hindsight, maybe I should have maybe added another egg or added something just to loosen the batter a little bit. But it's made now, so we'll see what happens. That bakes for an hour at 325. My guess is the cake is going to be a little on the dry side when it's done. But we'll know in about 60 minutes. Oh, it smells good. My. Quite. I'm gonna give that 5 more minutes. One yet. My cake tester. Actually, you're my cake tester, but this is to see if it's cooked or not. This comes out clean, that's ready. That come out clean. That's done. Yep. Give that 10 minutes, pop it in the pan. That one's done. Then we got to turn around. Now we got to make a white one because my dear wife can't eat chocolate or some chocolate, a little bit, maybe, kind of, depending on
not that.
Not that. So we have made the white cake quite often, and that's what I'll make next. So then we'll cut it in half, and we'll have half a white cake, half a chocolate cake. The other half in the freezer for tomorrow.
For tomorrow.
And that's that. Oh, that might be all right. Get these cleaned up. Now we're going to mix up the white cake. We've got our batter in the mixer. Made just like the chocolate one, except with the chocolate, of course. I'm going to do a third of this. Stir that around a little bit. It's almost together. And we're going to put in half of the yogurt. Stir it again. And then a third of this. Stir. Till it's almost together. And then the last of the yogurt. Stir. And then the rest of the pie. Someone call and look for a piece of cake. So, flatten that. Yeah, in the oven it goes. Same thing, 1 hour. Big reveal.
Bit see-through on the icing.
Chocolate and vanilla.
His and hers.
His and hers. Yeah. Yeah, probably be gone by maybe
Sunday
Sunday afternoon or so.